Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to chair the session. Unfortunately, this session is supposed to be chaired by Professor Tufail Ahmed. Because of some inevitable circumstances, he is not here. So instead of him, I am proxying his chair as the chairperson of this this presentation. This presentation will be the prevention of diabetes food, role of diabetologists. As you know, in who are practicing diabetes, you have know that if you compare with the non-diabetic population, the diabetic population has suffered from lots in the food problem, and ultimately they have to undergo importation. About 20 times more importation will be found in diabetic population if you compare the non-diabetic population. So this is one of the important topics today. If you think this topic is important for all the diabetologists because the suffering of the people and cost of the once a patient have developed food problem is more. So thinking of that, there is ample of evidence we need to how we can prevent food problem, and if the patient have the already developed food, how we can manage the patient in this a better way so that they can have a useful and productive life in their family. So I request Professor M.A. Basit. He is one of the pioneer in the history of diabetes management, particularly for the whole world. He is doing a lots of job on the food, particularly prevention of food care, and throughout the country of Pakistan, he is doing lots of programs on it, and he is very well known about the food problem prevention in the world. He is the General Secretary of Diabetic Association of Pakistan and Professor of Baka Institute of Diabetology and Technology, Baikan Medical University, Karachi, Pakistan, and he is the former Regional Chair, IDF, MENA region. May I request Professor M.A. Basit to start his presentation on prevention of diabetic food and what is the role of diabetologists in this aspect. Professor M.A. Basit, over to you.
at the same time do not have an extra cost. So for example, this kind of footwear in Pakistan, we are selling, if you talk of dollars, somewhere around $20 or $25, which considering the amount of input and the amount of science involved is honestly nothing. And what we are saving through it is that we in very high risk group were able to reduce the recurrence rate only 26%. Why should it be quicker? It is very hard. And if you look here, for low risk people, for the last 3 years, no ulcer developed. In moderate risk, no ulcer developed. In high risk, no ulcer developed. So prevention of the ulcers in the first place, and recurrence of ulcers only in very, very high risk people. But again, this project by WDF was shared as one of the best because it's footwear for every diabetic across Pakistan. Now, role of diabetologists does not even stop here. To progress further, to be able to represent low middle income countries and the issues related to these countries internationally when we develop a consensus group. So these are consensus documents, guidance, document guidelines every 4 years in Netherlands, 2007, 11, 15, 19. And then these guidelines have been translated in 26 languages, and we did it in our language, in Urdu, and disseminated across the country. Which leads to my final part of the talk, which is advocacy. We still do feel, and very strongly feel, that 150 foot clinics are not enough. Even 1500 foot clinics are not enough. For a country with a population of 200 million plus, having nearly 20 million diabetics, with, if we expect 10% ulcer rate and 2 million people with foot ulcers, and prevention of foot ulcers, as I said, to be the priority, 3,000 foot clinics plus are needed. And this cannot be possible without advocacy. Now, I presenting this data or presenting this lecture in front of an audience which have got a success model there in Bangladesh, I honestly feel I'm not the ideal person to talk in front for advocacy, because we are struggling for it. We need to learn from your experiences. We need to learn how the government machinery is involved with diabetes care so enormously, with the so highly dedicated, motivated, comprehensive team of Burdham and Badas. I think credit goes to late Professor Ibrahim Saab and his family as the legacy continues, with Professor Azad Saab following almost exactly the same footsteps, but at the same time taking Professor Ibrahim's vision leaps and bounds to new heights by the service. So advocacy. We started by having international conference in 2006, and pioneers in diabetic foot were champions like Professor Andrew Bolton, Professor Carol Barker, Mark McGill, and then for epidemiology, Rhys Williams, and then a very known figure in Bangladesh, same highly acknowledged figure in Pakistan, IDF President-elect, Professor Akhtar Hussain from Norway. And so here we developed at that stage Pakistan Working Group on Diabetic Foot with representation from all over Pakistan and starting the advocacy group. We then developed advisory board for the care of diabetes. And what we suggest, this is digital link. And every Wednesday, this board is meeting virtually. And if you can see, we are having cases from across the country discussed in that board every Wednesday and reducing amputation rate pan-Pakistan by use of digital technology. We wish and we are trying, we are working, that we are able to share this with the government and the ministry. And the ministry is able to take it over. Final part is for having a complete comprehensive data, we need to develop registry. Diabetes Registry of Pakistan, DROP. One of the components is diabetic foot ulcer, one is with gestational diabetes. Total registered patients so far, and this is the meeting with Ministry of Health, Public Pakistan Health Research Council, Federal Minister of Health, Federal Secretary of Health, and late Professor Shera, may Allah bless his soul, he rest in peace. He was the one advocating for diabetes care, for the recognition of our diabetes educators and foot care assistant courses, for recognition of our e-clinics and the diabetic foot meeting, and for having a gazetted notification for advisory board for the care of diabetes. Internationally, we continue to get recognition. As one of my colleagues, Dr. Zahir, has been working with us for the last 24 years, and now the lead of our diabetic foot screen has been elected as Vice President for IDF Diabetic Foot International. And this is Diabetic Foot, MENA Group, MENA region, Southeast Asia region of IDF. We are in Middle East and North Africa region, and that was developed in 2015. And we continue doing workshops across the region to reduce the amputation rate in the region. Finally, I would like to finish off by remembering my mentor, my teacher, professor, the person known for his diabetic services in Pakistan, across the region, i.e. MENA region, across Southeast Asia, even in fact internationally. So Professor Kusama Shera of Diabetic Association died in Karachi on March 2, 2020, he was 85 years old, and he has been working in there for 45 years and has served as various offices in IDF and has been an honorary president of the IDF. I like finally to thank once again the organizers, especially Professor Azad Saab, Professor Hajra Mehdar, and Professor Kishwar, and all others who have been working dedicatedly for the cause in Bangladesh. And I wish we are able to replicate your model in Pakistan. And I also like to thank the audience for sparing their time out. Thank you all for your attention. Thank you.